So 12th gen Intel is here, and a lot of you guys are probably rushing out to build a new PC if you've watched any of the reviews. Maybe ours, linked below. One thing that you'll soon realize is that other than the CPUs, brand new DDR5 RAM kits are also as elusive as the secret village of Talo from Shang Chi. So a lot of you guys have been PM30ing me to ask if DDR5 is actually even necessary. Today I'm gonna be reviewing the Dominator Platinum RGB DDR5 to see if it's actually better than DDR4, and if yes, by how much, and should you wait for it to be more available before building your next rig? Let's get cracking. So, DDR4 has been around since 2014, back when Taylor was still a blank space, Sia was still hanging on the chandelier, and Pharrell was still happy. Man, do I feel old. Anyways, any of you guys who have built a PC within these 7 long years will no doubt still have a DDR4 RAM kit or two hiding in your dust bunny infested machines. With Intel 12th gen being backwards compatible with DDR4, no doubt there are quite a few advantages to stick to the old stuff. You get to build a new rig faster and not have to wait for DDR5 to be more available. Also, you'll definitely save a few bucks because DDR5 is going to be a little bit pricier. But if you're a discerning PC enthusiast like me, a bangsawan, building a new gaming PC with a brand spanking new processor just to pair it with old tech is like rocking a new outfit but wearing your 7-year-old busted up thongs or flip-flops for you Americans. You can do it, but do you really want to? Also, because of the physical and specs differences between DDR4 and DDR5, the motherboards that support one will not be able to support the other. When you want to upgrade to DDR5 in the future, when it is more available, you will actually have to swap out the entire motherboard. So it's not exactly plug and play. Alright, let's take a quick look at what's changed with DDR5 in terms of the technology. On the outside, comparing our DDR4 Dominator Platinum RGB and the DDR5 version, you'll see that things are largely similar. We still get that sleek matte black aluminum heat spreader in a smooth satin finish and 12 individually addressable Capillix RGB LEDs that together make up my personal favorite RAM kit to date. In fact, I have 128GB of this stuff in my Threadripper workstation, and I've always enjoyed how Corsair implemented the RGB here, being very customizable and eye-catching without looking tacky like some of the other kits out there which shall not be named. Oh yeah, feel free to check out our IQ guide if you haven't already to find out more about Corsair's solution to RGB lighting. Now, outside of the similar physical dimensions, you'll also notice that the number of pins are the same. Both DDR5 and DDR4 DIMMs have exactly 288 pins, though you'll notice that they have shifted the notch or key on the DDR5 more to the center to prevent people from mixing up between the two generations of RAM. Under that heat spreader is where things get a little bit more exciting. There have been quite a few significant changes made to the specifications of DDR5. Without risking putting half of you guys to sleep, here's the tilde. Number one, we have a higher memory bandwidth. Initial DDR5 memory will get a 50% bandwidth increase over DDR4 to 4.8 Gbps, but eventually we are going up to the sky at 8.4 Gbps. This is very task dependent, so you might or might not notice any difference. And number two, we have a lower voltage. We're getting a lower operating voltage of VDD, which translates to a lower power draw. Number three, a new power architecture. The power management is shifted from the motherboard to the DIMM itself, which should improve signal integrity and noise as well as control over the power supply. This is also one of the reasons why Z690 motherboards that support DDR5 cannot physically support DDR4 as well, other than the different key positions. Number four, we have a longer burst length. This means that DDR5 can maintain higher speeds for slightly longer than DDR4. Again, this might or might not make a difference depending on the task. Number five, and finally, we have the higher capacity. Now, DDR4 DIMMs can go up to 64GB, but DDR5 can go up to 256GB per DIMM. That is more RAM than you can remember.
Wow, so lame.
Here's our test bench setup based on the Intel i9-12900K. We're using two different motherboards, one to support DDR4 memory and one to support DDR5 memory. We'll be doing a bunch of synthetic gaming and productivity benchmarks to find out if DDR5 memory actually makes a difference in your CPU and GPU performance. We're also doing a set of tests matching our DDR5 kit to the 4000 MHz on our DDR4 kit. Starting off with synthetic benchmarks, in Cinebench R20 we're seeing a less than 1% improvement with DDR5 for both single and multi-threaded tests. This is not very surprising considering the primarily thread-based workload here. I'd consider this to be a negligible difference. Then we have 7-zip where things got interesting. While there's barely a difference in decompression, in compression we're seeing a 25% bump with DDR5. We ran this test 5 times and still got very consistent results, so I don't think that this is an error. Next, we ran TimeSpy to see how RAM affects overall performance in DirectX 12. While DDR5 performed 6.5% better in CPU scores, it only led by 3% in GPU and overall scores. There's a difference, but not by much. Moving on to gaming benchmarks, firstly we have Shadow of Tomb Raider, which is an older title by now. We're seeing a 4% jump from DDR4 to DDR5. One peculiar thing that you'll realize is that underclocking our DDR5 to 4000 MHz tends to make it perform worse than DDR4 at the same speed. I would attribute this mostly to a higher cache latency on the DDR5 since I didn't spend too long tweaking the settings, but if I did, I would probably be able to get a tighter timing. In Cyberpunk 2077, there's only a 2.5% difference between DDR5 and DDR4. Again, not much. But in Death Stranding, the DDR5 saw a 6% jump over the DDR4 in terms of FPS. And finally, we tested a competitive FPS title, which is Valorant, and again, we only got a 2.66% improvement with DDR5. Finally, in terms of productivity workloads, we ran the Puget Premier Pro test twice, once in standard and once in extended. DDR5 seems to perform better in the extended test, leading by almost 5% at 4.8% over DDR4, which shows that you're more likely to appreciate an improvement when working with higher resolution footage like 8K. Moving on to After Effects and Photoshop though, we're only seeing a 1-3% difference, which is really not much. And what surprised me was the 7% improvement with DDR5 in DaVinci Resolve, which is slowly becoming everyone's favorite free editing software. Next, we have 3D workloads with V-Ray and Blender. Again, we are only seeing a 1-3% advantage on DDR5. So the truth is, as far as gaming is concerned, you're probably not going to see much of a difference moving to DDR5 offerings as of today. Now, whether or not newer titles can benefit from the faster RAM speeds and higher memory bandwidth from DDR5, only time will tell. When it comes to productivity tasks, whether it be 3D workloads or video editing, unless you're working with super high-res footage such as 8K, the difference is barely noticeable. Now, the only thing that we saw an improvement over DDR4, like with very conclusive numbers, would be 7-zip compression. So if you're doing a lot of that kind of workload, DDR5 is a no-brainer. So where does all this leave us? Well, if you want to be future-proof and not have to swap out your motherboard out in 1 or 2 years, then for sure go for DDR5. We're still in the very early days with the technology, so we should see a gradual upgrade in RAM speeds and capacity in the coming days, as well as maybe more utilization in games. As of now, you're not going to be missing out on much. And that is everything that I have to say about the Dominator Platinum DDR5 RAM kit, as well as the difference versus DDR4. I hope you find this video helpful, and if you do, please like and share and subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on more content like this. Also, feel free to follow us on Facebook and Instagram to see more shenanigans from the Mob House crew, and leave a comment down below if you have any more questions regarding DDR5, and if there's any kind of test that you want us to do, you know, and we'll try our best to actually reply to your comments and also do the test for you, because you know what? I love you. And I'll see you in the next one.